The Phoenix Green Chamber of Commerce will be getting a new start next week. The group is changing its name and fine-tuning its mission. The chamber is also promoting its founder and CEO, Mara DeFilippis, to its board of directors. Mara DeFilippis joins us now to talk about the changes. I said your name twice that quickly and didn't mess it up. So we're doing well so far.
So far, you're doing
well as well. Talk about your group. Let's call it by its new name.
Okay.
Green Chamber Greater Phoenix. What does a group do?
We promote, you know, we've had a change in our mission statement, which we're very excited about. We spent about 3 years really identifying what were the biggest needs in the community, and we took maybe 8 months to fine-tune that and develop it. So we're coming out August 1st with our new name, which is the Green Chambers, which is what we'll be known as. What do? We do a lot of things to support that. Really, the mission statement redefined is probably the biggest change, which drives everything else. That condensed mission statement, because I can't remember the whole long thing,
I got you.
Is really about advancing a sustainable and diverse economy.
How do you do that? Because I saw that. I actually wrote that down, advancing a sustainable and diverse economy. What does that mean?
That means that we provide a voice for the community that wants to be heard. We promote businesses. We engage with them. We network with them. We educate the community on some things that are going on that are possible opportunities for advancement for jobs so that they can get involved.
I noticed, I was going to go back to the name change. It's, you know, Phoenix Green and then now a Green Chamber. Were there concerns that folks were getting the wrong idea? Were there territorial spats going on? What was happening here?
What really was happening is there was a misunderstanding about possible boundaries, which we don't have. We serve the greater Phoenix area, and I think that this name change will help to relieve that problem. Really, there's no confinement. And we serve Scottsdale, we have members in Tucson, we have, our membership spans the entire valley as well as we have plenty of guests that attend our events as well from all over the valley.
The idea of balancing business practices with environmental concerns, talk about that dynamic and how some folks and some businesses that you think should get attention, you should think should be promoted, you're still looking for, I would imagine, as well. Talk about that, and how do they do it, and what do we need to know about them?
We have some very fascinating members. One of the ones that I love to give the best kudos to is the Hyatt in Scottsdale at Gainey Ranch. They have some amazing business practices. They're actually the international hotel that they use to validate other business practices and also to follow for the financials. So there's things that they do. They put up solar for their hot water heating. Next year they'll be putting a green roof on their hotel, which is kind of a big deal. These are, you know, things that are way at the front run of what's going on out there, and they're testing it and they're documenting the financial impact, which I think is the most important part of it too, to see what's a good idea to be doing for the rest of the Hyatts.
Indeed, but talk about the challenges in this economic climate of businesses that want to do these kinds of things but may not think it's the best time to do it right now.
That's a great point, and certainly probably the most argued point. I would say that businesses are looking for either a 1 or year turnaround for a break-even point on their capital expenditures right now. So with that said, there's plenty of opportunity for these businesses to make some small decisions on, you know, where are their resources coming from and how efficient can they be. A lot of times, businesses just running more efficiently can save money. You know, changing, modifying behavior is a great opportunity. And those really don't cost anything besides maybe posting something in the bathroom about turning off your lights or, you know, implementing a program.
Indeed.
Yeah.
The state as a whole, we can talk about the business community, the Valley's business community, but the state as a whole, the whole nine yards, are Arizonans serious about these kinds of issues, about getting green issues at the forefront, about environmental issues in the workplace?
I think at this point, one of the biggest reasons for the change, Ted, was because we were focused on those internal business practices that you were just asking me about. While those are incredibly important and we have a program developed to support that, you know, and we'll be using that to educate, the bigger issue, which I think was your previous guest talking about, is the economic condition of Arizona. So for us, we saw that as the one place that really didn't have a voice here in Arizona, that was being loud, that was being heard, and that was representing businesses that have some credibility and respect in our community. So we thought to come together and provide that forum to do so. So for example, you know, we are kicking off a mayoral candidate forum for the city of Phoenix on August 3rd, and that will likely be the most heavily attended forum in the history of this year with all the mayoral forums. We have 260 that we have to cap it at, and we've had to cap it already. So people want to hear about what the plans are to attract businesses, to stop losing good people and losing these businesses to other states.
Well, all right. It's good to hear about it. Congratulations and best of luck to you. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.